And just it would be interesting for you to also to know that the most troubled, the most dangerous community, barangay in the Bagong Silang, and it was based on statistics, more than 50% of the prisoners in the city jails came from Bagong Silang. This year, they were chosen by the National Police as one of the most peaceful communities, barangays in the country. We have 2,000 families who have homes in about 22 GA villages, but 10,000 of them have joined our Kapitbahay Association. And the president and the chair of the barangay captain is from our community. And we have entered into a partnership with Ateneo for public health. And we recently, we just inked about partnership with UCLA for public health, for us to be able to really train health workers within our community, for us to be able to build healthy communities and build a healthy nation. So from just addressing the issue of landlessness, homelessness in one area, we realized that there is enough land so that no Filipino will be squatted. And we realized that this is possible if we create what people share, we create shared value. That those who donate land will also benefit from their generosity. If you have 10 hectares of land and you donate 2 hectares, then you are able to put 100 families in 1 hectare, and 1 hectare can in fact be for food production and for livelihood activities. But what happens is that we trigger economic activities, we remove the ugly shanties around, we bring peace and order, land values start to go up, and what remains to the landowner also goes up in value. This happened about 5 years ago that in Murcia, Negros Occidental, when land values went up 10 times surrounding the Gawad Kalinga communities, and it was publicized. And now everyone wants to donate land, and we have land coming out of our ears. Before, land was a very contentious issue. So again, it is showing everyone that there is value to working for the common good. Before no one, before Gawad Kalinga, we don't know people on a massive scale giving houses to the homeless. But now we have SMART that has donated about 700 houses. Globe giving us also their own Globe buildings, donating 32 farms. Likewise, we have Procter & Gamble that came in to build their P&G buildings, and Unilever followed with their Unilever Vitality Village, and Colgate came in and donated 100 homes for the Colgate Smile Village. So again, we created shared value. And we were no longer treated as conventional CSR, but we are now part of the marketing plan. Because the CEOs have realized that investing in also reducing or ending poverty is good business. If you bring people up, because that's what we're doing, bring people up from extreme poverty to moderate poverty and give them middle class aspirations, it enhances the buying power, it expands the market base. And so it is, again, the co-branding. There's a paint company that will be entering the Philippines next year that has already started. Their entry point is to build, to paint Gawad Kalinga communities, using environmental paint. And so we realize that the world is turning also, is becoming kinder, is becoming more just, and that even corporations now are starting to practice enlightened capitalism, and that more and more people are going for profit with a bigger social conscience. So again, that's what has really amazed us, because also the amazing generosity and the greatness of the human spirit. Again, earlier I said I didn't want to be defined by Payatas and by Abu Sayyaf as a Filipino. Last April, I was in Sulu to turn over our Gawad Kalinga community, the houses, the goats, and the vegetable farm to the Tausugs, in the birthplace of the Abu Sayyaf in Patipul. And we also went to Panglima Istino, and I stayed in the home of Commander Bawang. He's 104 years old, and he's known to be the fiercest of the Tausug warriors. Anyway, what was really amazing was that we had 300 volunteers, and we felt it was the safest place for us, even during that time. the Red Cross volunteers were still in captivity, but they were released 2 days after we left the place. And so we realized that it is possible for ordinary citizens, if they learn to transcend their tribal loyalties, their business rivalries, their parochial interests, that we can alleviate poverty and even at a certain point really end material poverty the way that other countries have been able to do it. But we can do it following our own belief systems, because nations will be built according to the aspirations of its people, according to the values, according to their own principles. And so from Abu Sayyaf, Payatas is being transformed. There are 13 Gawad Kalinga villages in the former dump site where about 1,000 people, particularly children, were killed about 10 years ago when the whole garbage collapsed. And so this is the mission area of Ateneo students. Together with Father Benebres, we launched our partnership with Ateneo in 2003, and we had projects in Payatas. And when we launched after the typhoons, the four typhoons that hit the Philippines, we also launched the Kalinga Zone campaign to build 40,000 homes, provide land and homes and build communities for 40,000 families. And so together with Ateneo graduates like Manny Panglingan, who's chairman of Smart PLDT, and also Norman Cruz, who was secretary of defense at that time, Sito Lorenzo was the secretary of agriculture. So we have a lot of graduates that are just waiting for the opportunity to be able to work for a transcendent cause that will have impact on the lives of people, that will achieve scale, and that will be sustainable. And through a partnership and with attracting people to bring in their expertise. I am an economics graduate of the Ateneo, but I realized that the problem of poverty in our country, before it is economic, it is cultural, it is behavioral, and also looking at poverty from different lenses and different angles, and for everyone to bring in their expertise. So those who are interested in environment, we want to work with them so that they can plant trees and help us to count carbon credits, to teach us how to do the retail system of waste management, for us to teach them about rainwater harvesting, which is starting to happen because the former Secretary of the Environment also joined us, Secretary Bebe Gozon, in charge of our Green Kalinga. We have the CEO of Unilever Selecta, who claims that Selecta became the number one ice cream because 4 years ago they partnered with us, and then by getting 100% of the personnel to do community work by building the Selecta village, and they saw that the works of their hands could transform lives, and they started to become appreciative of all the privileges and opportunities they had. They worked harder, they gained the industrial peace, and Selecta became number one as an ice cream. And so now we're being asked by Keppel to build 300 homes in Batangas around the shipyard, because we have done the same thing for Hanjin in Zambales. And so it's again just working with every sector of society and looking at their own interests and the things that we hold in common. And whatever it is, whatever it will take to restore the dignity of our people, to trigger also to trigger economic development, to create abundance where no one is left behind. And so these are the values that we hold. So again, creating impact, scale. We partnered with over 400 mayors and people who have been frustrated and have actually experienced corruption and are frustrated with the businesses that they set up, are frustrated with the missions that they want, the good works that they want to do. They often say that it's impossible to work in the Philippines because of corruption. And I realized that maybe that is true, but in my case, I have worked with 400 mayors and I have not met a single corrupt mayor. I just hold on to my own policy that if I'm surrounded by dishonest people, I should just remain honest. And so even I believe that this is what I call our build philosophy. Just build the good in people. Just see the good in people. Engage the good in people and see the God in people. And so it is time for me to judge, because we are a compromised society, because Jesus also did not judge. So he died with tax collectors and with prostitutes. And so I realized that maybe if I just engage the good in people, even the worst of politicians probably is not 100% bad. There might be a 10% good in that person. So I will engage the 10%. You know, and maybe the 10% by engaging us in our own playing field, it will become 20%. It might become 30%. What if I engage 1,000 mayors, or only 1,600 mayors? Maybe the collective good that we can build together will overcome evil and transform this country. So again, it has been a journey. We launched this as a global movement for Filipinos to end poverty in the Philippines, and we also launched it for Cambodians to end poverty in Cambodia, for Indonesians to end poverty in Indonesia, just following our build philosophy. And the build philosophy is simple: engage, bridge, leverage. So we engage every sector of society, and they bring their expertise. We ask them, we have 2,000 communities. We will engage you. If you want good governance, lecture on good governance. If you want to teach catechism. If you want to help us with the environment, come, bring your expertise. So now we engage people, we don't judge. And then we bridge need with resource. We bridge between the Muslims and the Christians. We bridge between the rich and the poor. We bridge between government and citizens.